What's going on, guys? It's your boy Yardy Man here. Thank you guys for getting us to 100 subs. We are now on the road to 200 subs, so make sure you hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribed already, and also don't forget to share and like this video. And this is their reward. Really a match made in heaven between players of some time. Yo, what's up, peeps? Welcome back to this Colchester United Road to Glory career mode. I can see that you guys are really enjoying the episode so far. So today, we are going to bring this episode, obviously, to an end. And I'm going to show you what happened in this episode. So here we are, guys. I can confirm we have won the Premier League. Yes, this is the stats for this season, guys. I ended up playing through the entire season, and trust me, it's the most fun I've had on this game in a long while. Trust me, it was very competitive at times. It became hard in the beginning, it was hard, to be honest, but in the end, it just got easy when my players started getting in form. And you're gonna see some crazy stats right about now. I'm gonna show you how we got to 95 points, how we scored 111 goals, and yeah, how we got 30 wins, 5 draws and 3 losses. So to go through, guys, this was what was hella surprising for me. Sheffield, Watford and Everton got relegated. Arsenal in the 14th place, that's just shocking. Well, you can see top place was us, Man City second, Liverpool third, fourth for Chelsea, fifth for Leicester City. And it was a very long title race and we had to hold up in the end, but I'm going to show you how many goals Solanke scored, guys. Solanke scored 38 goals in 34 matches for us. Literally, he broke the record. I think Salah was the one who set the new record of 32 goals. He beat that by 6 goals, yeah? You could see another great player for us here was Saucedo, 13 goals in 22 appearances. He's just been spectacular this season, and hopefully he can take over from Solanke when he does leave the team. Another player now, Pedro for us, guys, scored 16 goals in 28 appearances. That was also another great start to the season for him. Well, ending to the season, he done very well. I'm going to show you guys assists, guys. We had all of the top spots, top 5 spots. So you could see Solanke 21 in 34 matches. Pedro 21 in 28 matches. Brian 11 in 30, not really that good. De Silva 10 in 26. He's not really attacking midfielder. I have actually made him now one, a center mid now. So he will be doing a lot better in the second season. He did score a lot of goals as well. Hack 10 in 32. He is a great player, but it didn't show with stats this season. And there you go, guys. Now, clean sheets, guys. We didn't get the most clean sheets with Mantle. We ended up getting 8 clean sheets in 17 games for Mantle. While Fuchel, another German player, ended up getting 9 in 18. So he was the better goalkeeper for us. Okay, so I've shown you guys everything in that department. I am now going to show you the squad and the formation. Hopefully you recognize the formation that we were using. And there we go, guys. We were using the 4-2-4, guys. So we're playing Brian on the right, just like this. Pedro here. I've also trained Pedro now to be a right wing. So what that means is he can take that spot whenever Brian is tired or rotating. I've also trained Hack now into a left wing, so he can play left wing, left mid, and a cam. We've also trained, as you can see, De Silva joined us as a CDM. I've trained him to a CM now. I am currently training a Son KO to a CM as well. It will take a bit. And who else do we train? I think Masingo did actually come as a CM. But guys, Saucedo, I ended up training him back to a striker because it didn't make any sense with this new formation to turn him into a cam. We currently don't use cams anymore. Now, Bellingham, guys, you can see here, he's a left winger. For me, he's not really doing well on the left. So what I'm actually doing now is training him
to a striker. So as you can see here, he's got decent stats to be a striker. His finishing is what I'm going to have a look at now, 86, guys. So I think he'll stand a much better chance in the middle. So I've actually trained him to a striker now. He will be completing it by next season. Reina, guys, I've changed him from a centre forward to a right winger, just because I thought he could actually, with his dribbling, he could actually go around players from the right. I didn't actually feel he would be great enough as a striker for us. So that's why I did do that. Now Ratchet, he was always a CM, but as you can see, guys, he done pretty well. Another player that done well for us this season was Jones, guys. Jones was impeccable this season. And I did bring in this new guy, Breton. You can see he's got a potential of 90 odd, guys, but we've only played him in about 20 odd games. So now I'm gonna show you the squad hub, and I'm gonna go straight into stats right now, guys, and we're gonna go through this as quick as possible. So Mantle, guys, 27 games in general for us. He had 10 clean sheets. That gives him a 6.5 rating for the entire season. Pretty good for us. He had 8 clean sheets in the Premier League. Christian, guys, you can see he had 21 appearances and 10 clean sheets. That's spectacular, man. Bazunu, he actually had 8 appearances and 1 clean sheet. He did do pretty well for us, but he's not really leveling up, developing as well as I want him to. So I may just get rid of him by the next season. And Lloyd Kelly, guys, 31 appearances, 2 assists, 8 clean sheets, 6.6, guys. And you can see his overall went up by +2. You can see Christian's went up by +2 as well. Mantle went up by +2. So Wijndal, you guys can see he had 30 appearances, 12 clean sheets. Pretty good. He went up by +1. We're not going to talk about clamping. He's going to be gone by next season. Todibo went up by +2. He had 36 appearances, 14 clean sheets, 1 yellow card, 6.8 rating this season, guys. Van Drongelin, he went up by a +3. 40 appearances, 1 goal, 2 assists, 17 clean sheets, man. 6.9 rating. This guy is a beast. If you are doing a road to glory, buy Rick Van Drongelin. Trust me, he's a beast. Another beast, guys, for us, went up +3 this season, is Rhys Oxford. 30 appearances, 9 clean sheets, 1 yellow card, 6.7 overall rating, guys. He's a pretty great defender. It's just in the first season they weren't really playing him that much, so we had to really play him this season to get him to level up. So I want to see if he can get higher than 80 anyway, but he's a really good player that you can buy on your road to glory. He's very good at defending. Now Mateo Brayton, 15 appearances, 1 clean sheet, guys. As I said, he's a young youth. He's 18 years old. We are planning to get him to his highest potential, which is 90. So I'm going to keep him in the team. But as you can see, he went up by +2 this season. Yoshida, we're not going to talk about him. He's going as well. But you can see that he went up by +1. Now, Aarons, guys, +2 for Max Aarons. 38 games, 14 clean sheets. That gives him a 6.60 rating for the entire season. Now, Frimpong, guys, he's another player who we were rotating with Aarons, and you can see he's leveling up pretty quick. He's developing pretty quick. 80 rating now. He's gone up by +2. He has 31 appearances, 1 goal, 2 assists, 7 clean sheets. Pretty decent, guys. Asun KO, 47 appearances, 9 goals, 5 assists, 18 clean sheets. That gives him a 7.4 rating, and that's the highest rating I think so far in the midfield. But here we go again. The Silver went up by +3. He had 38 appearances, 6 goals, 11 assists, 14 clean sheets, and a 7.4 rating also. So as you can see, they've done pretty well in the Premier League and also in all of the leagues, to be honest with you. Masingo, again, Masingo done pretty well this season. I gave him 33 appearances. He scored 1 goal for me, 2 assists, 7 clean sheets, 6.8 overall rating. Guys, Ratchic is a bloody crazy player. Trust me, he's going to be great probably in the next season as well. We are going to hold on to him. Now you can see here, 30 appearances, 5 goals, 5 assists, clean sheets 4, and he's had 7.1 overall rating for the entire season, guys. Trust me, he is a beast. Hat, guys, he's had 44 appearances, 11 goals, 13 assists, 15 clean sheets, 7.2 rating. The goals is not spectacular, but he was pretty good this season. He had a lot of assists in many games, and when I did play him, he did score the major goals that we needed. Plus 3 for him, you know what I mean? He's at 88 now. Now, Bellingham went up by plus 2. There you go. He had 32 appearances, 2 goals, 6 assists, 6 clean sheets, 6.6 overall rating. Not pretty good. Not good at all, guys. But as I said, I'm turning him into a striker now. So hopefully he can score more goals. And he is also 20. So, we're going to see how it works out. Brian, guys, he has had 42 appearances, 12 goals, 13 assists, guys. 17 clean sheets, 7.1 rating again. And as you can see, he's went up by plus 2 overall this season. So he's getting to that 90 overall. And he's been doing great for us. He's been scoring in the major games. And he's pretty young as well, 24 years old. We did try to train him to a full striker, but I don't really like how he plays as a striker, because he's currently left-footed and his right foot, weak foot anyway, is terrible. So I may have to train his weak foot more. Now, Pedro, guys, this is a guy that's overperformed for us this season. I knew he would be overperforming the way from previous seasons when I did buy him, but because I was simulating, I didn't get to see these great results. But in 39 appearances, he has scored 23 goals for us, 25 assists, 9 clean sheets, guys, 7.8 overall rating. He's had 16 goals in the Premier League and 21 clean sheets in 28 appearances. Damn, man, that's beastly. He's gone up by a plus 3 as well. Giovanni Reina, guys, plus 1. He's had 26 appearances, 2 goals, 2 assists, 5 clean sheets, guys. And as I said, I haven't really figured out what I'm going to do with this guy just as yet, because he's not really performing. I don't know if we're going to have to get rid of him or train him. Salonke, the big man, plus 2 this season, guys. And for some reason, his stats won't move any further. I'll show you real quick. That's all I'm seeing there is the green sign. I don't know if it's still working, as I'm not seeing any of his stats go up. But anyway, guys, in 46 appearances, he scored 46 goals, 26 clean sheets, assists, 18 clean sheets, guys. The highest average rating this season, 8.4. And in the Premier League, he's at 8.7. In 34 appearances, he scored 38 goals, guys. That is beastly. Now, we are going to move on to Eddie Salcedo. And as you can see, guys, 36 appearances, 16 goals, 13 assists, 11 clean sheets. And his overall rating was 7.3. Guys, this guy is going to be a beast for us in further videos, future videos. Trust me. This season, him, Pedro, Solanke, they were beastly, I'm telling you. When I was rotating between all of them, they were beastly. That's all I can say about it. I have no complaints about him. Guys, his stats, he's going to be a beast in the future. That's all I can say. Another beast for us, guys, was Ricky J. Jones, guys. I was pretty scared with his stats when I started this season, because he was 67 and I didn't know, 66, and I didn't know if he was going to play good, guys. This guy plays like a beast. You can see he's got 92 pace, 84 agility, and 71 balance. And his finishing is pretty decent as well. 70. So this guy does finish, 93 overall. He is a beast, guys. Trust me. Don't worry about the stats. I've learned that from playing this guy. He scores in major games for us against big teams, little clubs. It does not matter. He scores. In 22 Premier League appearances, he has scored 10 goals, 8 assists and 3 clean sheets. We're not really bothered about the clean sheets. But in total this season, he scored 16 goals and 12 clean sheets. As I've said before, he's a beast, guys. Now, for the end of the season, guys, I can show you guys real quick what's the highest valued player on our team. Or I'll show you the highest valued players anyway. So we'll organize it like this anyway. So there we go. Brian, 182 million, 106 million for Aarons, 98.5 million for Hack, the Silver, 82, etc. Senkeo 71, Mantle 63, guys. He's going to become one of the best goalkeepers in the game by the next 2 to 3 seasons. Pedro 52 million, Bellingham 51, Ratchik 46, Todibo 44, Wijnaldum 43, Van Drongelen 40, Lloyd Kelly 37.5. Lloyd Kelly's a beast left back as well. Solanke 30, guys, but in this career mode, I think I could actually sell him for about 70 or 80 million, so that's just his value, but he does sell for more than that. Frimpong has been great for us. As I said, he's going to be a beast in future seasons. He's pretty fast as well. Reina, Salcedo, Reece Oxford, Fushu, which was one of our best goalkeepers as well. Masingo, pretty great as well. All of these players, guys, that's their value. So from the most expensive to the most cheapest, I've shown you guys that. I'm going to show you guys what we won this season. So if we accomplish our board expectations. So we did finish the season with a profit margin of 157.5 mil. Because I haven't simulated to the end of the season, that hasn't gone through yet. But don't worry about that. Everything's going to move pretty. Once I simulate, that's going to go on green. Now, reached the semi-final, guys. I can confirm we won the Emirates FA Cup. Now, they wanted us to reach the semi-final and we actually won it. Now, for this youth development, as I said, I've got 6 players in my youth team that I could potentially play them in 10 matches. I've done the long-term goal anyway. But as you can see there, San Juan, crucial player to the defender role. We did that already, guys. So that was our objectives for this season. And guys, as you can see, another thing, profit. We made a total of 476.75 million. While we literally spent 174.75 million on players. Literally. Yeah, so you guys can see we earned all of that money back from prize money, transfers, match tickets, pre-season prize money, season tickets, merchandising. And I'm going to show you guys right now what we won, exactly the trophies that we won this season, guys. So there you go. We know we won the Premier League. Definitely, you know that now. Emirates FA Cup, guys, we destroyed Liverpool and won that 3-0. Now, Carabao Cup, you guys are going to be surprised. We won the treble. So there you go, guys. 4-2 against Manchester City. We destroyed them. It went extra time and we scored some deadly goals. I've got videos. If you guys want to see that, just leave your comments down below. And I might just upload that as special content. Now, yeah, literally, guys. Yeah, we won the treble. So we won the Premier League, the Emirates FA Cup and the Carabao Cup. So now you guys have seen how great this team has been this season. Let me know what you want to see more from this team, guys. Do you want to see them go and win the Champions League? Let me know. Leave your comments right now and let me know, guys. I am actually going to go and give you that evidence now of the Premier League. I'll let you see the Premier League first when we won the Premier League. And yeah. So here we are, guys. This was when we won the title. This confirmed it. Trust me, guys, the feeling, you can see the players right now how excited they are. The feeling was out of this world, I'm telling you. This is the first time I've actually won the Premier League with Colchester. I've done it with Gillingham before, but Premier League with Colchester has been one of the fun. They're probably the most fun I've had playing this career mode, I'm telling you. It was spectacular. And there it is, guys. There is a Premier League. So I'm showing you guys what we won, guys. I'm showing you the evidence right there. Literally, as I said, I played through the entire season. I'm sorry I couldn't give you guys any more content. But if you do want more to see what went along, I've got some crazy goals I scored with Solanke, Brian as well. You can see. There it was, guys. There it was. A magic moment. We are the champions. Fans were literally excited and happy for the entire season. I hope you guys, if you're a Colchester fan, I hope you're happy and excited as well. because I did a lot in this career mode for you guys, literally. Know what I mean? To see us lift this trophy today, guys, it's unbelievable. This is our first Premier League title in this career mode. And we've literally won about two or three titles so far going in the previous season. So yeah, that was it, guys.
Well, to win any league, Derek, you have to have consistency, you have to be dynamic, demanding of your teammates.
So it's just for the group picture right now, and you guys can see all the players there that contributed to us winning. You know, Salcedo is right there in the middle. Hack was on as well. I think the next one I'm going to show you guys is actually the Emirates FA Cup. Okay, no. So here we go, guys, against Liverpool. Solanke finished off. This was a beautiful game as well. We destroyed Liverpool. You can see Drongelin. He's mainly our captain. The only way he's not our captain is if I take him off and put someone else on. But this is when we completely destroyed Liverpool. And this was for the Emirates FA Cup. I'll let you guys see the little celebration. A single there, guys. Trust me, this whole squad deserves it. Not one player let me down this season. I'm telling you, every player was playing as if they wanted to win the league, guys. I couldn't believe the way they were playing attacking football. There we go. Beautiful. We lift the bloody cup. The Emirates FA Cup, guys. We have won it. There you go, guys. The fan was excited. I'll just skip a bit through it. There you go, guys. Pedro, guys, again, as I said, he's been spectacular this season. So there you are. This was the final squad picture. Everybody taking a picture with the cup. And as I said, it's well deserved from the lads. I think I'm actually going to show you now the Carabao Cup, if I can actually show you that. If I can find it, I will be able to show you guys. This is the Premier League. I think this was a Carabao Cup.
So much pace on it too.
Guys, this was a beautiful goal from Brian. A beautiful free kick against Chelsea. That was the battle going up to the Premier League. Going challenging for the Premier League, guys. So there you go, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and look out for more episodes from this Colchester series, guys. I'm thinking about what to bring to you guys next, and I've got some pretty good ideas. But if you've got more ideas, guys, just jot it down in the comment section, you know what I mean? Thank you guys for supporting all of these videos. We're literally going up to 200 subs real quick as well, because we're currently on 165 as I'm doing this video. So I just want to thank you guys again. Take care of yourself. Love. Thank you guys for watching the episode. If you've enjoyed it, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Also smash that like button. We would like minimum for all our videos to be on 50 likes. So make sure you smash that. Leave a comment. I'll see you in the next video. Like a candle, I'm out.